At this time, we'll begin the news conference, and we'll be taking questions from the media. We'd ask that you raise your hands so we can get you a wireless microphone so that we can, so everyone can hear the question. So if you get your hands up, we'll get a wireless to you.
Coach, when you made this decision to come to Kentucky, you said you can bring the program to a national prominence. It's really not been there in a long time. What makes you think at Kentucky you can bring it to a national prominence?
Well, Kentucky's had success, and the key will be to build on that success and be consistent with it and take it to another level. I believe I could bring a strong staff that will help and build in recruiting. I believe in this administration and the commitment that they're willing to make to the football program. And, you know, so with the recruiting, quality staff, development, develop the players that are here, that we can take it to another level.
Coach, during this process, as you were weighing the option, how much did you talk to your brothers, and what would your father say to you at this very moment? What advice?
My father would tell me to follow my heart and do what I believed, you know, was right for myself and my family, and visited with my brothers about it from time to time. Not a ton. You know, we've had a few conversations, but to me it was a no-brainer. You know, I was excited and anxious for the job. I wanted to be here. I believe in this program. And like I said, you know, we're chomping at the bit and ready to go, and I feel like we have a good group of staff that's willing to come. So it was an easy decision for me.
Coach Stoops, to your left, welcome to Lexington.
Thank you.
Everybody in this room, believe it or not, even the media wants you to succeed.
Thank you.
Can you explain what you need to do to change a losing culture, which is what this is, and turn it into a winning culture, which will make all True Blue fans happy?
Well, first of all, we're going to embrace the process. You know, we're going to attack each and every day. What I'm worried about right now is meeting with our players tomorrow morning, and we're looking forward to going ahead. Really not interested in what happened before. We will embrace the past. Yeah. We will embrace all the past great players and the past teams, but we're worried about going forward, and we're going to do that by, again, it's a process. We're not too worried about the results right now. We're worried about the process, and that's getting my message to the players tomorrow morning, and then from there getting out and putting together a quality staff and moving forward.
Coach, when you talk about that you can feel you can bring a good staff to Kentucky, could you just kind of update us on maybe what your plans are and kind of how that is going to come together?
The plans, I'm planning on going out and interviewing a few offensive coordinators here real soon. I've been in conversations and feel real good about the prospects for the offensive coordinator. And so I'm going to head out on the road and talk to a few people and put together the offensive staff first. I feel very good about the defensive staff. I feel like I have my defensive coordinator targeted and on board and ready to come. And so from there, it'll really concentrate on the offense. You know, I realize with my background in defense that the offensive staff and the offensive coordinator will be critical to our success. So that's priority for me right now.
Mark, speaking of the offense, I think you're a defensive guy. I think maybe the big question in this room is, what kind of offense do you want to run here?
Yeah, we're going to have an offense that you guys are going to enjoy. I promise you that. I don't know, where's Tim Couch at? Is he around here? Hey, Tim, we're going to have an offense that you're going to be proud of. We're going to get out there and rip it around a little bit. We're going to throw it, but you have to be creative. You know, I'm a defensive guy. This is the SEC. You know, it's a very physical conference, and I realize that. And I want to be tough, and I want to be physical. And, you know, we have to build this foundation with great defense. There's no way around it. If you don't play great defense, you're not going to win consistently. Yeah. So. But with the offense, again, I want somebody that has a plan, that's been successful, and we have to be creative. We will have a physical presence about us, but we will spread it out, and we'll use some bells and whistles to get the run game going and again, be a little bit creative.
Coach, right here, there are in the middle here.
Where are you? Okay, sorry.
You know, there were a lot of openings across the country and several other ones also here in the SEC.
Mm-hmm.
What specifically drew you to Kentucky, made this one more attractive than anything
else?
The
Big Blue Nation. I feel very good about Kentucky. Again, I just felt very comfortable visiting with Mr. Barnhart. I feel very confident in Dr. Capiluto and the Board of Trustees and their commitment to taking football to another level. We have everything we need to be successful here. Sure, we want to improve on a few things here and there, but we have what it takes right now to be successful. You know, it's our job to coach them, to put them in the right position, to recruit, and to develop this program and turn them into a consistent winner.
Mark, could you talk about what role Tim Couch had in this process and how you know Tim and so forth?
Had a chance to visit with Tim on the phone a few times. He was involved in one of the interviews. And you know, I understand the impact that Tim has on this university. And again, I want to lean on Tim and visit with him about some ideas, you know, because he's been around football. And I just enjoyed talking to him on the phone.
Coach, back here, you talked about having what it takes and having what you need to win here, but what kind of conversations have you had about moving forward, about facility development and things like that?
I'm sorry, can you repeat?
You talked about the fact that you believe you have what it takes to win here. Can you tell us, though, about any conversations you and Mitch might have had about facilities in the future?
That's really not for me to discuss. That's for Dr. Capiluto and Mitch Barnhart to discuss. I know there's some... there's a process going on right now that they're working through, so I think I'd like to refer that to them.
Yeah, you know, I'm fine. We've been working in concert with the university on facility plans and on a lot of fronts, and Dr. Capiluto and the trustees have been tremendous about working through all those details, and obviously, as Dr. Capiluto referred to in his remarks, there are pieces of that will have to happen for us to have authority at the legislative level, and we're working through that. We want to do it in concert with what is best for the university. Clearly, it's an important part of our program in moving football forward. So I think everyone's aware of that. Hopefully, we'll be able to move on that and get some more information out on that soon.
So, Mark, if you could talk a little bit more about the interview process. You took the job then sight unseen, and what did you know about Kentucky?
Yeah, Mr. Barnhart and I met just over 3 weeks ago. It came at a perfect time. We had a Thursday game, and so I was free on a Saturday. It was just after the position came open, or shortly after that, and we had a chance to meet and go into great detail about Kentucky, about what my plans were, and so we talked at length that particular day, and then we've had ongoing conversations since then. And again, had conversations with a group of people that I mentioned earlier on the phone with a conference call. And so that's kind of how the timeline went.
Mark, could you elaborate on that a little bit? During the interview process, what was your sales pitch to Mitch and company that you don't need to look any farther than Mark
Stoops?
Well,
I don't know if it's a sale. I don't know if there is a sales pitch. You know, I'm very much, you know, I am who I am. I think, you know, you'll get to know me as we go forward. But you know, it's all about recruiting, developing the players that you have, and developing them as total people. And, you know, that's what I'm all about doing things right. But there's no, you know, there's not, I'm very much of a meat and potatoes kind of guy. You know, I have a plan and we have a vision, but there's going to be a lot of hard work and a lot of consistency in what we do.
Over here, Coach. What do you see as your biggest challenge going forward here?
I'm sorry, we're
over here.
Okay, sorry.
What do you see as your biggest challenge going forward here?
Well, it's a tough conference. You know, you have to be physical. And so, you know, I think it's of great importance that we develop our strength and to be able to compete at this level. We have to go out and recruit, and you got to recruit each and every day, each and every year, to keep on building your program.
Mark, just to clarify, had you been on campus before the last couple days or today? And if not, what have people in the coaching game, friends of yours, told you about Kentucky football?
I had not been on campus, but yes, I have had friends and people that were here just this past summer and just discussed it with them. But no, I had not been on campus.
Coach, from a recruiting standpoint, what areas do you plan on targeting? I know you got Florida and Ohio.
Yeah,
background.
Kentucky, obviously, we're going to recruit Kentucky hard and take care of our home. We're going to recruit Ohio very hard. Yeah, I have strong ties in Ohio, and there's very good football players in Ohio. We'll work through the Carolinas, into Georgia, and in Florida a little bit.
Mitch, I'm over here. Mitch, on your right. There was another question about this. I want to just clarify. Did you make some specific commitments to Coach Stoops about improvements in facilities in terms of recruiting him? Just say we're going to do X, Y, and Z, or try to do X, Y, and Z?
They've been plans we've been working on for a decade, to be real honest with you. So it's nothing that's new. It's something that we've wanted to work on and do some things in terms of facilities in general. We came here, our facility package as an athletic department was probably not where it needed to be to compete in the SEC and most of the sports that we've got. And we've systematically taken them piece by piece and been able to, one way or another, find ways to improve our facilities. There's a couple major ones out there left for us to figure out. Obviously, Commonwealth Stadium is on everybody's heart and mind, and we pay attention to that every day, and that's something we've been doing for quite a while. Dr. Capiluto has been very, very honest and very forthright with us, explaining how he understands the things we need to do to get better. So is there a specific timeline? No. But I would say that we're working on it sooner rather than later, and that's where we are. We can't, all we can do is go to work every day and try and find a way to make progress on that. The other one obviously is baseball for us, and that's a concern as well, and we've got to work our way through that. The other ones, we're trying to work our way through the normal processes that we've been doing for the last period of time. But specifically, obviously, football is on everybody's mind. That's what we've got to pay attention to.
The football coaching staff here had a Broyles Award finalist, Mike Summers. Are there any of those guys that are here or leaving that you would consider at all to retain?
Yeah, absolutely. You'd consider them. And I have not had a chance to visit with the coaches yet. And I will, and absolutely you would consider.
Coach, over the past few years, there's been kind of an influx of defensive philosophies. We went from the 4-3 to a weird 3-3-5 stack. Is there a certain type of scheme that you feel UK can succeed in moving forward?
Well, I think, yes, we'll be very defined in what we do now defensively moving forward. We'll play with four down. We'll be 4-3 personnel. And of course, we'll be very multiple from there. But again, I have a very clear vision of what we want to do defensively. Our players will know after the first spring exactly who we are and what we're all about. So we'll start there and lay that foundation and build from there.
Coach, in the back, as I understand, there are a lot of current players here and you haven't got to meet with them yet. Could you tell us what message you're going to tell them tomorrow morning, just a little bit of what you're going to tell them about this upcoming season?
Well, I'm going to tell them to look forward to it. You know, a lot of coaches take these positions and try to scare them and tell them how hard it's going to be. It's going to be hard. There's no way around that. We're going to work hard, we're going to train hard, we're going to do things right. They're going to be accountable, and they're going to be dependable. And there's just no other way around that to be successful. But I'm going to enjoy coaching them, they're going to enjoy playing for us, they're going to enjoy being a part of this Kentucky family, and they're going to hold their heads high walking around this campus.
Mark, the recruits that have already over here that have already verbally committed, to Kentucky. How do they factor into your future plans, and kind of what do you hope to accomplish in recruiting?
Well, we need to make sure they're going to fit our system. It would be unfair to them if we took their commitment and didn't fit what we're going to do. So we have to evaluate and work our way through that process.
Coach Stoops, back here in the back, what was your reaction when you arrived at the airport, when you arrived here today, and you saw all these people here to greet you?
I felt like it was game day in a way, you know. It started, it's exciting. I really appreciate it. I appreciate your support. I look forward to working for you. And, you know, it's just an exciting time for myself and my family. We're really anxious to get going, and we understand it's going to be a great challenge, but that's what we embrace, you know, embrace the process. But the fan support and the people, everybody's been terrific, and we really appreciate that.
Mark, the one concern we've heard among the fan base is he doesn't have any head coaching experience. Is that a legit concern? How do you compensate for that?
I understand that. You know, that goes with the territory. I've been successful. If you look at where I've been, I feel pretty good about each and every place I've been. We've been successful. So I don't plan on that stopping now. Yeah.
A new quarterback.
Yeah, there. Yeah.
A great arm. Heck of a throw. Right.
Yeah. Mark, you said you've got a defensive coordinator targeted and probably on board to come. I don't know if are there any staff names you want to unveil today? And also, if not, more vaguely, do you expect some of your Florida State brethren to come with you?
I'm not permitted to talk about them right now. They need to go through the hiring procedures and all that. So I just got on campus, so I really rather not discuss any of that. And I really don't want to discuss any Florida State coaches. It's unfair to the players back there at this time.
Coach, over here. I know here we have a pretty good basketball team. Have you been able to talk to Coach Cal any? And how do you plan on working with the basketball team going forward?
Yeah, I enjoyed talking to Coach Cal. I had a great conversation. I had a couple conversations with him and really enjoyed it. I'm going to embrace the tradition in basketball, take our recruits to the games and enjoy it. But I really look forward to working with Coach Cal. And it'll be good. You know, he's from Pittsburgh. I'm from Youngstown. We're not that far apart there. So.
Mark, did you approach UK or did you, back here, I'm sorry, way back here by the cameras.
Okay, sorry.
Did you approach UK and Mitch Barnhart or did Mitch approach you about the job?
Yes, I reached out to Mitch and inquired about the job, yes.
Could you explain why?
I was excited about the opportunity. I thought I answered that earlier, but I'm excited. I'm really excited. I think it's a great opportunity. I believe in Mitch. I believe in Dr. Capiluto. I believe in the vision that we have to get this thing done. We want to be winners, and it's going to take everybody. It's going to take all of you that are out here today. It's going to take the administration. It's going to take coaches. It's going to take players. We're all in this thing together. To win at the level that we want to win at, it's going to take all of us together to get this thing done.
Mark. To your left, you've been described as a player's coach. Is that accurate? And if so, what does that mean?
I'd like to believe so. I take that as a compliment. You know, discipline is never a problem. And, you know, generally with defensive coaches, discipline's not a problem. So I feel very good about the relationships that I have with my players. And yes, I think it is my style to find different ways to motivate players and to get them on board and get them to believe in themselves. So I think players all need to be coached differently. They all have different personalities, they have different backgrounds, and it's your job to figure that out and push the right buttons.
Mark, back here, you mentioned winning and level of success, but what is the level of success that you believe that this program can reach?
To play in the SEC championship game. Yeah, and to win it. Correction, not just play, but play and win.
Coach, back here.
What is your perception of the level of talent in the state of Kentucky vis-a-vis other states that you've worked, and is that a concern?
Obviously, there's not probably as many SEC caliber players in Kentucky, but there are some, and it's our job to get out and work hard and to recruit and keep the great ones home, and to take any player that could help us win and take them and develop them and mold them to be winning players for us. So I understand that there's not as many in this state as others, but there are some good ones, and it's our job to keep them home.
For Mr. Barnhart or for Coach Stoops, could you discuss the terms of the contract, which we haven't seen yet, and kind of how you got to those numbers as far as how long it goes?
I'll take that. That's sort of where I'm one of the few things I do. So, we've got a five-year deal we put together for Mark, and it's roughly the base value is $11 million over the 5 years. That contract will be handed out at the end of the press conference from Tony or the staff over here on the right, and they'll get that squared away for you in terms of that. There are incentives involved, and which escalate. But the markets change. It is changing rapidly, and I think we've got to be fiscally smart about the way we do our business. And we're in a very, very competitive environment. And we wanted to make sure that Mark knew we wanted him here. We wanted to make sure that he knew we were committed to football, and that he has got the resources in terms of dollars to go out and get the staff necessary to get it done. And so that's never been an issue for us. I think there's a misconception out there about that. But we're glad to have him here for not just five, but a lot longer. If we get this thing going the right way, we're going to have a lot of fun together, and that's what we want to do. We want to make it someplace where the Stoops stay for an awfully long time.
Coach, what's your first impression not only of the Big Blue Nation, but also of Lexington, your new home?
It's been fantastic. We did a flyover when we came in this morning, so had a chance to see the whole city. So, yeah, I've been very impressed. It's a beautiful place. I've heard nothing but great things. Everybody that's come through here and knows the people here just speak so highly of it, and just been very impressed with the people. And so I'm really looking forward to moving and getting to be a part of the community.
Coach, back here in the back, can you take us through the decision-making process of not coaching Florida State in the bowl and kind of how that came about?
I just think there's too much work to be done. It's hard to be in two places at one time. This week alone was extremely challenging. We agreed on Monday evening, so it was a very long and stressful week for myself. And to try to go through that again, I don't think it's right for either side. I'm here. I'm working for you now, and I'm a part of the Big Blue Nation, and that's where I want to be. And so, but there is always a balance there, because you know how I feel about my players or my past players at Florida State, and the journey that we've been through. So I plan on being here, working full time for Kentucky, going through the whole process, and then if I can go back and help around the dead time when the recruiting ends and there's some dead time, I may try to go back and help a little bit with game planning. I'll do whatever I can do to help Florida State win the game, especially if they play Louisville.
Coach, welcome to Kentucky again.
Thank you.
What ties do you have to Kentucky, if any, and was that part of your decision in coming here?
Not many ties, but I do now. I have all of you. So not many ties to this point, but that's part of our business, to get in and get to become a part of the community, get to know people. So we're really looking forward to that.
Mark, talk about some of the coaches that's really had an influence on you that you've worked under.
Yeah, thank you. That's a good question. There's been quite a few. I mentioned my father. Of course, that's a big part of who I am and how I grew up. I had the opportunity to go play for Hayden Fry at the University of Iowa. And that was just a tremendous experience as a player and as a graduate assistant coach. I got my start with Hayden Fry, and just a tremendous person. I then went to South Florida, coached for a year under Jim Levitt. Went to Wyoming, coached a few years there under Dana Dimmel. But I'd say, you know, the influence would be, you know, starting with Hayden Fry and my father, and of course my brothers. And then the last 3 years at Florida State, I think it's really gave me a good vision for what I want to do as a head coach with some of the structure and the way you structure the organization. So I've had the pleasure to work with Coach Fisher the last 3 years, and that's also helped me. Of course, you know, my brother Mike and my brother Bob, you know, they're just resources that I'm always going to use. They're people that I lean on each and every day with my brothers. So, we obviously talk and rely on each other.
We have time for a couple more up here, Dan and Matt, and a couple more, and we'll be wrapped up.
Have you had any chance at all to evaluate the current roster or had any impressions of what's already here?
Not too much, really. We agreed to the contract Monday night, and I was a little bit busy trying to stop that triple option last night, so that kept me quite busy. But after we meet a few people here tonight, I'm ready to get to the office and get working right now.
I know you don't want to talk details, and you said Mitch would talk about it at a later date, but did you feel like you had to get some assurances on investment, et cetera, in facilities? Were you okay with how it is now? I mean, how did that play any part?
Well, I think when Mr. Barnhart and I talked at length for a long time, I believed in him, and I believed in what we had here and what we were moving towards. So, I think that's a big part of it.
Okay, any other media questions? Got time for a couple more. Okay, got Kent there in the back.
Mark, you mentioned Louisville briefly. What are your thoughts? What do you know about that rivalry?
Oh, I know it's a good rivalry, and we're going to embrace that rivalry, and really looking forward to it. I've had some great success in rivalry games, so looking forward to that challenge.